Good afternoon and welcome to BizTech's Asian Midday Market Watch. Today is National Day in Singapore and we have a special guest that's joining us today. He's Gabriel Yap, Executive Chairman of GCP Global. Now, Gabriel is a REITs specialist and is a top 20 investor in many REITs on the Singapore Stock Exchange. Now, Gabriel, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me back, Brian. It's been quite some time.
Yes, it's great to have you back. But before we get your insights, Gabriel, I'm going to take a look at crypto markets as well as regional stock markets. Now, Bitcoin is at 23,868.2. It's up 2.27%. Ethereum is at 1,778.75. It's up 3.89%. Now, looking across the regional equity markets, Singaporean and Indian markets are closed today for a holiday. So we start with Bursa Malaysia. Bursa Malaysia is up 0.12%. Shanghai is up 0.26%. The ASX All Ordinaries is up 0.12%. The Nikkei is down 0.93%. The Hang Seng is up 0.86%. Rounding up the numbers, we've got the Kospi, which is up 0.39%. Now, Gabriel, what's your view on how markets have performed in the first half of the day?
Well, I think the markets basically got nervous ahead of the Federal Reserve aggressive stance on interest rate increases. Right now, the verdict is still out there as to whether we get peak inflation this quarter or next quarter. But the clear thing is that, Brian, is the fact that equities, REITs, real estate investment trusts always discount ahead, as what we have always taught in the last 33 years. And essentially, you would see, you know, a possible bottoming of this real estate investment trust, you know, this quarter, next quarter, taking into account that interest rates may already peak next year. You know, so while the indicators like inflation, PCE, core PCE, Michigan Business Index may still be showing deteriorating effect, but in GCP Global, what we teach is to look at the incremental changes. And if this incremental changes is actually slowing the process of the increase, then you have the momentum going ahead for real estate investment trust investors.
Okay, Gabriel, I want to get your insights because obviously you specialize in this area. Walk us through the first half of the year and how REITs have performed and what were the challenges?
Right. It's very classic, Brian, because the last time when Singapore had its, or Singapore REITs experienced its first interest rate increases, that was between 2004 to 2006. Unfortunately, at that time, there were only four REITs listed in Singapore, and we do not have any record of basically how they performed. Then the second one actually started in December of 2015, right up to December 20th, 2018. So in the spate of 3 years, real estate investment trusts in Singapore initially suffered a correction of 16% prior to the first interest rate increases. And then after that, interest rate, despite interest rate increases, of which you saw nine increases, where the Fed increased the Federal Reserve rate from 0 to 0.25%, right up to 2.25 to 2.5% on 20th December 2018. REITs basically initially suffered correction, but after that, they started to move up. It's only during the process in 2018 where the Federal Reserve went on an aggressive bid to increase interest rates four times out of the nine times in 2018. Then you actually had a correction on REITs, but then again, that REITs correction was only 12.8%. But if you are an investor, as what we have been advocating all these years, that you will help the REITs, the respective REITs, from 2015 right up to 2018. There were 26 REITs that went through that cycle. 14 out of the 26 REITs, that's more than 50%, Brian, actually posted positive gains during that particular period. And we see that happening in this particular interest rate upcycle as well.
So if you see that happening, what are your holdings like in terms of REITs currently?
Well, actually, for our classes, you know, investment, REIT investment classes, the next one is actually this particular weekend, where we teach for investors education. In fact, we've been seeing a lot of investors that have set up family offices in Singapore coming to our classes. In this regard, actually, we are very gladly thankful to the OUE group that now has emerged as the venue sponsor for our REITs program going ahead from fourth quarter onwards, which means, Brian, that from now onwards, our REITs classes, which is held on a quarterly basis, will be held in the prestigious Hilton Orchard Singapore, thanks to our venue sponsor, OUE. But in regards to your question, the key thing for REIT investors now is to watch for a few things. One is the peaking of the 10-year bond yield. Two is the inverse relationship between the 10-year and 2-year bond yield. Three is the volatility or the underlying volatility of the VIX index. Fourthly is the earnings growth coming out from the US. And of course, because you are REITs and you get paid on a coupon basis, the DPU growth is key in assessing this. And all these variables we cover completely, comprehensively in each of our various REITs quarterly classes.
Now, Gabriel, thank you very much for your insights and thank you very much for coming on the show today.
Once again, my pleasure and happy National Day to everyone.
Now, we've been speaking to Gabriel Yap, Market Strategy, Executive Chairman at GCP Global on BizTech's Asian Midday Market Watch. I'm Brian Fernandez. This video and podcast will be on our various platforms as well as our website, www.biztech.asia. Please like and subscribe to our various platforms. Thanks again for watching.